Hey guys, match two, Flapajack from England, Godwin from England, or UK, whatever you want to call it. I don't know which one you guys prefer. You guys from England, let me know. Flapajack going an assault squad. No, that's a regular squad, and he's playing as Japan. Godwin going UK, and that is that's a assault squad, plus a few singles. Ah, militia squad, straight away. Militia squad plus assault squad, that's an interesting opening. Two squads in one go. But Flapajack had to wait for the recruit squad later on. And just want to reveal something to you. I just found out, I can't believe I didn't know this, but the Japanese conscript squad, recruit squad, has 150 MP compared to the others, only 100 MP. So that's a big bonus right there. But interesting, he's gone a regular squad instead of the assault squad, making the recruit squad come in a bit slower. Using the stonewall here to have a staging area to possibly assault the west. Center, though, has been totally lost here. Flapajack is not going for any flags but one point. Oh, that's a kettle bomb grenade. Boom! That's a nasty one. Takes out the house in the process. Goblin pays him back with a nasty cook grenade. So the numbers are now going to zerg across this point, and flanking mentality grenade from Flapajack will finish off the remaining forces of the UK chaps in the vicinity. Western point down. Flapajack takes it out with the numbers. Center Godwin is capping without any resistance on the eastern point as well. No resistance, and that is why you go for three flags. That's my opinion, and that's Godwin's opinion too. It's the old known wise tactic here. So even though he lost the eastern, he's got two flags and comes out of that better than Flapajack, I think. But Flapajack has a good position now, able to defend the western point from the stone wall of the usual allied side, and has this flanking stone wall that can shoot down to the center. Godwin, though, playing it safe, is hiding behind this house capping from back here. Godwin's got a full squad just laying outside, pinned down, assault squad kind, and also coming up with another assault squad. And Flapajack's interesting play at the moment. He's focusing every single energy into this area, sending another full squad, recruit squad down this way. Just not going for the other flags at all. Godwin. For some reason, Godwin has Flapajack's icon. Just don't mind me. Remember, it's the vice versa. Replays are kind of bugged. If you play a replay after another replay, some things go wrong in terms of the icons. But Godwin icon is Flapajack. So Flapajack trying to flank his Godwin's forces. It's interestingly playing so deep into the western area. Not sure the purpose of this yet. Interesting, Godwin could definitely have sneaked a guy across this whole way without any sort of interference as well. Godwin now filling his gaps a little bit. Flapajack moving back, afraid. Just going to play a bit more safe. He's got so many guys in this flag. What is he expecting? He's expecting the entire UK army to come here or something. He's just, everything's here, but not much being done at this stage to try and get another flag. Godwin has enabled Godwin to actually get a very forward position using the center stone walls, which is usually the axis walls. And now, fortunately, Flapajack caught in the open, but this will definitely change the situation. And Godwin will now be forced to pull back, whilst the one special point, 80 rifle grenade infantry, now takes advantage coming in. Oh, gets a bit damaged coming into this. Now in a decent position to shoot out. Flapajack recruits have spotted the sneaky Godwin guy and has been dispatched. Now venturing into the great unknown of the eastern northern area, Flapajack finally. And now making a move into the center area. It's interesting, this is farmland by the way. I just never knew what this area was. This is, I never knew. We've been throwing grenades over this little building for like 200 years. And what is this? It's so small. It's like got a chimney. It's like a giant chimney for such a small area. Ah, I never even thought about this. The coal area right here. So it's burning coal. It's a power plant of some sort. Huh? I don't know. What is it, guys? Do you recognize this type of machinery? It's got some water pressure valve here. I don't know. I'm interested. Let me know. Crusader. Two pounder. Definitely not an evil type building, if you know what I mean. But ICS Crusader, taken out quickly by the AT rifle grenade from Flapajack. That's definitely going to turn things around, this one over here. And that's a big loss from Godwin now. Sending just militia to the center. Though, on the other end, Flapajack doesn't have much infantry of his own either. Now, here's the, I think this is the regular, no, it's the home guard, I think. It's home guard. Oh, no, that's not the home guard. It's only one MG in this. This must be just the regular squad. Setting up on the stone wall at the center. Though unable to really participate in any shootouts because Godwin's got his guys behind the buildings. Still holding on, 18-0. The ICS loss may not be that detrimental as expected, as this wall here proving to be a good cover for him. Flapajack now trying to evade that though and push further in behind this mysterious building. And we'll start now capping the flag, and also has a good position to start coming to this flag. Got an MG here waiting. Ooh, full recruit squad as well coming in. Blackwatch will get there a bit too late. We'll fight off a recruit squad in a position of ambush, I'm guessing. Got a buy here of the ICS, so Crusader ICS spawn. But here's a 3-cap now. Turnaround from Mr. Flapajack. Some nice grenades by the recruit squad. Got to return some of the favors. Actually falling back. Lewis gun finally being put into the fray. And has a decent shot, though. Now going to get flanked by an assault squad. Got to also an MG. He has a regular squad, actually. He needs some support. Some chaps have called call to arms. Oh, wow. Jeez. The greenhouse is falling on top of the Japanese. Whoa, damn it. Speaking of being an old man, of diverting away from the cast a bit. I've been being into gardening recently. I've just been doing gardening non-stop. I'm setting up lots of veggie patches and... never mind. If you want to see it, just let me know. If anyone is into gardening, I'll be happy to show you my garden and to discuss the plans and show how everything's going. Anyway, back to the cast. Got an only gun going from Godwin. Crusader. So that's why I haven't been practicing, pretty much spending all my weekends on the garden. Crusader going to the left, Olicon coming to the left as well. Blackwatch sandbags in a very back position, expecting to be assaulted again. It's just Flapajack's assault in the start was definitely not in the way. ICS gets some good shots off, as Godwin is now paranoid and playing ultra defensive. 20mm, now going to hide. Olicon now in a position to come into this. There's not too much infantry in the area, so should be able to take it quite easily. Center going to Godwin as well from this house. Oh no, sticky guy just in the middle of the flag. Blackwatch now coming in. Oh, should be able to get in there. Flak's definitely the target. Godwin hits down the protection. Probably another 20 shots because the ICS doesn't usually hit its mark. Pretty wrong. Oh, it does pretty wrong. Oh, that was a direct hit. Pulls it apart into 5 pieces. Olicon now going to a nice position to cover this flag entirely. Perhaps even go right here. It's a really nice position to cover both flags. And you can easily retreat behind multiple buildings if required. Chinu out from Mr. Flapajack. Also coming in with the AT infantry. Recruit squad on the right, not going to have much luck. AT infantry in the center. Not sure why, there's actually nothing to take out, so not going to be an effective unit. Though Flapajack is pushed in quite deeply into Godwin. It sounded very, very nasty indeed. Very deep in Godwin right now. Godwin's line is definitely behind his lines, indeed. Recruit squad. SMGs nothing of weight. It really hasn't got much option on the right side. Chinita is going to try counter, perhaps, or maybe he's not. I think he's maybe scared of some sort of six-pounder. Six-pounder is out now from Godwin. Chinu is not taking the bait. He probably could have killed the Olicon before the six-pounder got there, but Flapajack is just making sure, playing the cautious route. He's just going to be content with holding the two flags. 20 to 19 has taken the lead from his older mate from UK. So far in this group, it's been hard to predict, really. We've got Mr. Nat and Godwin tying. So if you tie, you get 1 point. If you draw... Yeah, sorry, if you win, you get 3 points. If you lose, you get zero. So it's one apiece for Nat. Flapajack's got three because it's beat Pringles. Pringles has 0 points at the moment. And if Flapajack wins this, he'll get 1 point. Godwin will get one. So still very questionable who will come out of this group. Chinu going to the left to respond to the half track. Godwin seems to be into this type of tactic where he's got a Crusader A in one area, half track in the other, just focusing on the infantry killers and using the six pounder to do the tank killing. Half track now moving away behind the house. Flapajack's MGs from the black. Oh, this is definitely the home guard MGs. Holding in strong on the eastern area. Godwin coming in with a militia squad. Ooh, type 97 mortar. Going to the western side. Very far away, but we'll be able to put away the emplacements quite easily. Boom! So you're so far away. Look at the distance where it landed and what it killed around. Very far. It's so lethal versus emplacements. And pretty much all of Godwin's emplacements. Pretty much. they're sending their letters home to their parents in Devonshire. This guy has already wrote home saying he's dead. Sorry, Mum. I'm dead. I'm going to get killed by HE Shell very soon. Now, M4 half track. Boom, dead. I wonder if it's the same in World Wars. Pretty much half tracks are just fodder in this game. If you're a half track driver or half track in a half track scout car, your rate of casualties are higher than other forces in war. ICS Crusader. Makes sense, I guess. I've seen it happen in Saving Private Ryan with the German recon. Tom Hanks and Matt Damon ripped up the guys. The bazooka hit the half track and they ripped them up. Makes sense. I guess it's quite realistic, I think. It looks realistic to me. Got that. Also had that 20mm scene with that tiger. How it took out the infantry like infantry killers are meant to do. It wasn't like the infantry killer in Saving Private Ryan. But the BAR is definitely not that powerful. What do you call that guy? I can't remember his name. He flanked them with the BAR, just took out all the guys so easily. That's Tom Hanks' pistol is definitely OP. Took out a tiger tank. Jokes. Oh, horrible. That mortar doing good work now, so this is definitely the trump card of Flapajack at this stage of this game. ICS, though, could be deadly. Missing its target. Now Flapajack can be relocating. Chinino will be instrumental in protecting this. Six-pounder moving to the right side. There we go. Got the AA being quite... It's quite cool to see how the AA was evaded. It's been quite, quite ineffective in this game. Hasn't been many targets exposed to it. Godwin hasn't been giving him much. Oh, this guy could be deadly for the Chinu. Oh, forced to MG him. Six-pounder in ambush. Didn't see that. He's out of range though now. And now the mortar is definitely going to target him. We're waiting for the Flapajack mortar. It's on reload. Oh, six pounder is definitely out of there quickly. Get out of there, shit. ICS. similar to the other game. Godwin's he likes the UK nation, that's for sure. He loves this ICS unit. Six pounder. Moving in closer as Flapajack does hold onto this flag with the skin of his teeth. 36-19. Oh, opens up on the Chinu, doesn't hit the mark. Still in range, misses again, bounces again, I mean. One more shot perhaps? Oh yes, maybe. It's tracked it. Oh no. Bad luck with Flapajack. Bounces though. Good luck with Flapajack. Retaliation shot from Flapajack. Who's gonna roll the dice? Who's gonna do it? Oh, turret's down. I think Godwin may do it, but no. No protection. Again, Flapajack may do well versus six pounders and infantry. Infantry-wise, in the other game, he took it out. Oh, no, what is he doing? This guy just decides not to do anything. The biggest fail in the history of this game. Biggest fail in Flapajack's tournament history right there. Got the crew A now coming in here. Now the mortar will be, oh, nasty shot here. The full squad in the open. Very clumped up right now. Send them packing. Oh wow, that didn't do much damage to this guy. Very futuristic sounding turret movements by the British Crusaders, I must say. Or maybe just didn't put enough oil. Followed by Mr. Leslie, the tank commander. That's angry from last game. Recruits. Oh god, I've just gotta really gotta tone back the dad jokes, yeah. I pity my future. My son's future, in fact. Wow. Got 20mm. Is that he did capture that? He did capture it. It was a Japanese 20mm. Mortar puts it away quite easily. But this is a very commanding position right now. Godwin with the Flapajack icon just dispatching all the infantry, coming in so close, no counter in sight. Chinu is down still. Six pounder has not chosen to finish it off, perhaps in the out of the line. No, it's in the line of sight because it's totally decrewed, so it's on the map now, showing it's already repaired though, and unfortunately the opportunity has long passed Godwin. Just like his wife, because he's old already. .50 mil, and another suicidal half track coming in. Oh, it's gonna do a playbook of Shutter. It's coming in without any care for his life. Oh, a lot of things had to go wrong for Flapajack there for this guy to got through. Could have happened. This guy is such a oh, freaking this guy's evil, man. Shigachiya Ida. Wait till he gets off, then we'll kill him. Kill him when he's not unconscious. Make sure he feels the pain. Militiaman. Crusader AA. So Godwin coming back into this, 26-47, got the majority of cap, has the crew AA in the center, and also the ICS has some decent units on the field on the other hand. How did this guy get turreted twice? Must have been for the six pounder, I missed that. Has a good option to come back with the mortar and this steel, but at this time, Godwin's superiority will be in the hands of this crew AA. Just needs line of sight, send one guy forward, then let the crew A go boom boom boom, nom 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 nom. This guy repaired very fast. No, it's not. It's actually got the engine damage too. Looks got that little... Is that the engine? A little dot on the left-hand side? Because the turret's not flashing, the gun's not flashing, it's the back. And the gun now is flashing. I thought the engine would be back here. I think I need a plumber right now for this building. So look inside there, there's actually nothing. Why is there coal here? That's a power station, I suppose, is it? Like, why is there a power station with no controls, nothing? Don't understand. There's no logic whatsoever, DMS. Flapajack. It's farmland, I guess. I never realized that farmland is called farmland because it's got lots of greenhouses. It's a farmland. This is some irrigation system. This is some irrigation system that's powered by coal. Some very old-fashioned coal. I don't know. Don't know. The mysteries of farmland. But it's definitely important to these Japanese. This is might be quite disappointed. It's not a rice field. It's a greenhouse. Perhaps they just have to eat some cabbages, some sour cabbages. Sensor cap by Flapajack. We'll take that on the eastern point. Got Godwin capping that. Tulip out. Wow, that's a big, big one. You saved the money up for tulip. We've got so much big units on the field right now. But tulip's a good counter for that mortar. We'll eventually get it, but still no big tanks and snow. Wow, that's a horrible shot. King going for 50. 50, and indeed, that's what he should do. Oh, Godwin just has to fight it out now, and not looking good. Oh, he's got a good angle, though. Oh, no. What's going to happen? It's going to decide the game right now. Oh, bounces. Oh, bounces back. Flapajack has a good side shot. Oh, shit. It's, oh, wow, bounces. Lucky, lucky bite. Oh, Godwin gets a turret. That is so lucky. Turret attract everything, and tulip. Good on you, mate. Not only known for your rockets, but definitely did a good job at tank killing there. Multi-talented tank indeed. Definitely a risky play. That happening. It's just horrible. It just your heart gets pumping when you see a tulip or a calliope fighting out a Chino or a Panzer G for a 50-50. It's not worth it, man. Stay back. It's like the tulip has so much else in his life to look forward to. Like, he's a scientist that's going to cure cancer, but he's working at KFC. And I don't know, that was a horrible analogy. 75mm towed to here. ICS on the field still. We have to counter that, perhaps. But does take out the crew AA. Oh, nice. Definitely straight into tow. Flapajack escapes with his life. Mortar still trained on the center and still holding onto the points. CP wise, Godwin is definitely struggling, I'm guessing. He's got the crew AA, not dead. Almost 20 CP. That's probably almost 20 CP. That's probably almost 20 CP. So he's going to afford two squads on the field at a time, perhaps. Just a little bit more, I think. I'm not sure how much the ICS costs in CP. So 75 mil going back. Just going to plonk down very aggressively, and no, it's not. Going to just run away. Maybe it looks like he's coming. The tracer mark on the top left, moving it up the hill. Gonna protect this assault of the paratroopers. Gonna try to take the eastern point. Grenade, 59-37. Should be able to take it. Superior firepower. Boom. Damn. It's funny, this laundry is still immaculately clean. We have a Wind's farmland, has some free pants and free linen out there. Water peppering away in the west. Looks like Flapajack has managed to cap all the flags just with the infantry superiority. Godwin struggling to get enough infantry to contend. ICS Crusader trying its luck, it's not gonna do too much. 66-37, Godwin really needs something, needs a flag soon. Assault squad, part of an assault squad now coming in on the west. What's holding it? Why is it like this? There's nothing in there, right? That was weird. It wasn't ticking down. It was like stuck on Flapajack's cap, I don't know. Flapajack has some guys in the greenhouse areas. Poor guys. These guys don't know that this greenhouse will just fall down and crush them one day. What are they growing in here? There's no lettuce, nothing. 75 mil coming in to do some countering. Flapajack coming with a crew squad. Oh, peppered by that Crusader ICS. And maybe... Oh, nice shot. Doesn't do much. Just gets out the one of the crew. ICS, oh, getting shot at. Tulip! Oh, just takes out the crew once again. No luck on the number generated from Godwin. ICS misses again. And precariously holding onto this one flag with this one guy in the crater. And struggling to get any infantry to the flag. The militia squad coming in. There's no CP at all. Perhaps he should just go charging with the crew AA, to be honest, or something. Tulip is needed. Tulip's definitely a crew AA. You just need to go in there, to be honest. Oh, maybe not. I don't know. Oh, ICS has taken the... Oh, it's damaged the mortar. Hasn't killed it. Crew AA is in a good position to support the assault in the center, though. Yeah, perhaps do what you're doing, Godwin. You know better than me. It's just because it's... It can support the center and the right. You don't need a big force with a 20 mil. 20 mil can do all the killing for you. Just need the one a few units to spot. And that's what Godwin's plan is right now. And he does so. We got Captain Center now. And has reign over the left-hand side to guard. But here's the Chiha Banzai. This is perfect. Chiha Banzai. It's going to be hard for the Tulip to fight. Tulip's the only tank-killing unit here at this stage. Chiha stops in the very perfect moment to take a nice shot. Perhaps... Oh, wow. All the guys sitting in the tank got killed. Tulip fires in, fires at the Chiha. Other Chiha's coming, I'm guessing. Oh, it's been tracked. No, there goes the Chiha to Tulip. Where's the other Chiha? Unfortunately, not using succession to punch a hole. That would have been pretty nasty if the other Chiha came. But Tulip, it's very hard for the Tulip to fight two of them. Crew AA down. And the Chiha, that's the ICS, I'm thinking. ICS. Had its ass turned. Godwin holding on to the skin of his teeth. 37-88. Crusader AA now coming out again to play. Oh, it's a full S in the left. Soldier squad, but lucky is the crew AA. Crew AA is going to be instrumental in this holding this flag. Oh, it's done so well. Takes out nearly the full S in the left squad. Only three remaining. Though the dangerous ones are still there, the MG plus the two bazookas. Oh, what's coming out? Take out the MG and you'll be laughing. And right now, oh, collateral damage almost. This guy escapes and may do well, in fact. And he will do well. There's only... Oh, it's spotted, though. He's spotted, so perhaps no, he won't do well. Oh, what was that? Chiha comes out. Tulip, oh, couldn't do anything about it. Chiha's just mowing down the assault squad with the machine gun. Oh, Tulip can't do enough damage in time. 94-37 is going to get the 3 cap. And there you go, Flapajack has won, Godwin has quit. So that's a draw, 1-1. So far Flapajack is 4 points in the lead in group. Group B. Godwin, 2 draws. Nat, 1 draw. So wow, Flapajack is looking good. Alright guys, yeah, I'll catch you around. Good game.